A very warm good evening to one and all present or very auspicious occasion, you can say. We are going to organize this online webinar on very important topic, that is English in competitive examination. Well, friends, all together we are 21 participants over here, and the rest of the participants will join as per their convenience as soon as possible. But without wasting much more time, let us start with this webinar. Said the subject of this webinar is English in competitive examination. Friends, there is no need to tell you the importance of English language in our daily life. English plays very important role in our life, and when we look at the scenario nearby, we experience that there is a scarcity of employment, and many of our students, they are turning to the competitive examinations. At our college level also, we can say that we have very good response from the students who are going for a competitive exam, and some of them have been selected in different departments as they are very serious in their competitive exam preparation. And every one of them experienced that English is a very important subject into competitive examination. In considering all these things, the Department of English, Shri Gnanesh Mahadharga, has decided to organize one webinar which should be highlight this importance of English language in specially competitive examination. Of course, every faculty is having important and compulsory English subject, arts faculty or commerce faculty or even science faculty. But we experience that all the students who go for competitive exam, even many B.Tech also competitive exam, and we experience that English plays very important role in that examination. And that is why, considering all these things, we have decided to organize this seminar on English in competitive exam. And for this purpose, we have invited our guest, a resource person for today's webinar, Dr. Sanjay Shende sir. So welcome, Sanjay Shende sir, on behalf of Shri Gnanesh Mahadhar Navarga. The chairperson of today's webinar is the principal of our college, Dr. Suresh Bakre sir. He is also present over here. Before going to start, I would like to request Dr. Bakre sir to give the introductory remark on occasion of this webinar in competitive examination, importance of English language in competitive examination. So thank you. Over to Bakre sir. Bakre sir, please.
Namaskar. Good evening to you all.
Good evening, sir.
Respected resource person of the today's webinar, Dr. Sanjay Shende sir, Associate Professor, Shivaji College of Science Arts, Rajura. Respected head of our Shri Gnanesh Mahavidyalaya, Dr. Ujjade sir, Professor Shirsagar sir, my faculty member, and all other respected faculty members and dear students. At the outset, I congratulate Department of English for organizing webinar on the subject English in the competitive exam. As you all know, friends, English is the most preferable language for the official work all around the world. Hence, to develop competency in the language, it is the need of us. Certainly, this webinar will motivate and develop the confidence among the students. I am very happy to see here Dr. Sanjay Shende sir as a resource person on behalf of Shri Gnanesh Mahavidyalaya Navarga. Welcome you, sir, and thank you for, as you are going to deliver a valuable talk on the subject, which is very much relevant in the current scenario. Before I conclude, we must as today we are celebrating the World Environmental Day, we make one commitment that we will not pollute water, air, environment, and ourselves to celebrate, to commemorate this World Environment Day. Once again, thank you all joining this webinar and making it successful. Thank you.
Thank you, Bakre sir. Thank you for your introductory. Dr. Sanjay Shende sir, to do brief of Sanjay Shende sir. Sanjay Shende sir is working as an assistant professor in English. Shivaji Arts Commerce and Science College Rajura, District Chandrapur. He has been actively working in the field of teaching English language and literature for last more than 20 years, both at UG as well as PG level. He has successfully completed his doctoral research work on portrayal of marginalized caste and classes in the novels of Mulk Raj Anand from Gondwana University. He has also completed a UGC minor research project as a comparative study of English language teaching in English and Marathi medium institutions. Moreover, he has actually participated in 66 national and international conferences. Then he has organized 3 national and international seminars and conferences on NAC and English literature. He has published 23 research papers in various national and international UGC approved journals. Apart from these credentials, he has published, this is very important friends, apart from these credentials, he has published 6 books so far, which includes single authored book, English Language Teaching and Medium of Instruction, published from Lapp Lambert Publication, Germany, in September 2020. Last year, he has published this book. Along with that, this is very important that he has edited 5 books. The edited 5 books are as follows. First one is Teaching English Language and Literature, Challenges and Solutions Instruction. This is published from Lapp Lambert Publication, Germany, in November 2020. After that, the second book is Environmental Protection, Critical UK in March 2021. Recently, he has published this book. Then the third is Beyond Horizon and Incontinental Anthology. This is published by Bureau of Publishers, New Delhi, India, in May 2021. After that, Studies in Contemporary Indian English Literature. This is published by New Delhi, India, recently in May 2021. And the fifth book is Mapping Postcolonial and Subaltern Perspectives, a Reading Through Indian Literary Text. This is published by Notion Press, Chennai, India, just recently in June 2021. So this is a very wonderful biodata of Dr. Sanjay Shende sir. I am extremely happy that we have such a bright scholar in English language and literature in the form of Sanjay Shende sir. Along with that, there is under publication work, Gender, Resistance and Subalternity, Musings from Indian English Literature, and Educational Publisher New Delhi. It is going to publish very soon. So I hope all the best, Dr. Sanjay Shende sir. And today's topic, as I said, English in competitive exam. This is a very useful topic for all the students, any faculty student. Now I request the today's resource person, Dr. Sanjay Shende sir, to start with his presentation. The topic is English in competitive exam. Thank you so much. Over to Shende sir. Shende sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ujjade sir. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, yes.
Okay. Just wait. I will share my presentation. Then I will begin my talk.
Right, sir.
Is my PPT visible, Dr. Ujjade sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, 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 it is.
Okay, okay. So thank you, Dr. Ujjade sir for introducing me with kind words. And at the very outset, I must congratulate Dr. Lalit Ujjade, Department of English, and the principal of Jnanesh Mahavidyalaya, Dr. Bakre sir, for organizing such a webinar series where different topics are being presented before the students, because we know that in this pandemic situation, most of the things are happening on virtual mode, and to utilize this as an opportunity, this is a very good initiative taken by Department of English, Dr. Lalit Ujjade and his team, through which different topics, different speakers he is inviting, and students are given a kind of a resource on a variety of issues. I must thank Dr. Lalit Ujjade also for giving me this opportunity to interact with the students of Jnanesh Mahavidyalaya Rajpura. I know that their college is also having a competitive examination guidance center, and in our college also similar situation is there. We have been running a competitive examination guidance center for last some 5 to 6 years, perhaps more than that. And I have been a referring faculty to interact with the students of my college on this particular topic, that is English in competitive examination. In fact, we deliver our lectures on various topics, whatever that comes into the arena of that competitive examination. And today I have got this opportunity to interact with you. So the topic which I have selected for my presentation is English in competitive examination. And as Dr. Ujjade sir has quite briefly and very precisely, he has underlined the importance of English in competitive examination. There is no doubt in arguing over the issue that there is a need of English in competitive examinations or not. Okay, we will discuss these various issues in various slides, but before embarking upon the topic which is specific, I would like to discuss some more preliminaries. Now, as I consider that for the today's youth, especially the graduates and postgraduates who are studying in various colleges throughout India, for them employment, as I presume, it is a very crucial issue, because in the past 3 to 4 years, or maybe the more than that, our unemployment rate has quite drastically increased, and therefore how to get employment, how to get a job, how to become a jobber, or how to start a particular work, or how to seek a particular employment. This is the biggest issue, because we see that many graduates and postgraduates, after having many more degrees, they are not getting job. And moreover, second thing is that the students who undergo education of traditional programs, especially BA, become BSc, and they simply clear or pass these degrees with average kind of marks, they do not have much more preferences in the jobs. So the biggest opportunity for today's youth, I think, is to face the world of competition, competitive examinations, to appear for various competitive examinations. And that is the only platform where their original merit and their potential and abilities can be utilized, as well as they can be rewarded suitably. So this is the biggest and very critical issue. And how to deal with this issue is often a topic of discussion and deliberation. Now, if all this graduates and postgraduates who are seeking education in variety of institutions, if you really want to seek employment, if you really want to become or to grab a certain position, then these are some kind of things that you will be highly in need of. You will need skills, because without skills, I don't think that you will get a kind of a job. Now in case of in the context of this particular topic, English in competitive examination, this is more important that unless and until you have command over good skills of language, you cannot go further. Regarding other jobs also, you will find that if you have good skills of engineering or whatever technical skills, then you can survive. So you need to have skills, you need to have a good knowledge of your particular topic, and along with that you need to have good attitude, positive attitude. Okay, because unless and until you firmly believe on your potential, you cannot go further. And that is why skills are necessary, knowledge is necessary, attitude is also essential, positive attitude is essential. Along with that, the last but not least, hard work is also essential, because nothing happens automatically. I was a student of science faculty up to intermediate class, and during my education I learned Newton's two laws of motion. Out of that Newton's first law of motion, I often remember that everything is in state of rest or uniform motion unless it is acted upon by external imbalance force. Now even though it is a scientific law, but as a student of literature, I take it in another term, from another perspective. I consider it as nothing is possible, nothing can happen with you without any kind of action. Nothing will happen in your life if you are not doing anything, if you are not putting your efforts. The things, the situation in which you are, the same kind of situation will be there as long as you do not put your special efforts to change it. So that is why if we want some kind of change in our life, then we will have to make our initiative, we will have to put our sincere efforts. And that is why if you are really aspire to get a particular position onto or to clear a particular examination, then you will need to have these kind of things. That is, you will need skills, you will have to improve your skills, you will have to enhance your skills, you must have a good knowledge of your particular topic, your attitude should be positive, and of course you should be very much ready to put hard efforts. Okay, now the topic that is English in competitive examination, let us first try to understand what is the basic difference between traditional course examinations and competitive examinations. Okay, just wait, this dialog box is actually interfering my PPT, so I'll adjust. Okay, so when we look at the difference between traditional examinations and competitive examinations, we find that as you students are going BA, BCom, BSc, or later on you will go for MA, MSc, MCom, like that. So these examinations are absolutely and entirely different from the competitive examinations. Why they are different? Because in this examination there is a minimum passing criteria is there. If you are appearing for any examination in Gondwana University and the paper is having 100 marks, and if you get 35 marks, you will pass that examination. So in all these examinations, passing criteria is rather there, minimum passing criteria is there. Second thing is that for getting these minimum passing marks, you don't have to put all of your efforts. With the minimum efforts also you can clear the examination. If your target is simply to get 35 marks, then you can manage with that. So for getting 35 marks out of 100, it becomes a very easy matter. So here minimum efforts also can help you to clear the examination. Okay, then third thing is, while appearing for these examinations, you are actually not competing with others, you are simply competing with yourself. When you are appearing for BA second or BA final year examination, so you are not competing with others. Okay, you are simply showing your performance, trying to show your best performance, and then you will do it. And in these examinations, for clearing those examinations, there also maybe they may have some kind of shortcuts. Shortcut means that is, if there are 4 units prescribed in your syllabus, and if you are simply preparing 3 units or 2 units, even then you will be able to clear that examination. So this is what we find in clearing the traditional course examination. But when we talk about competitive examinations, So there, these things are not applicable. Now, as in traditional course examination, minimum passing criteria is there, but in case of competitive examinations, selection is not done on the basis of minimum marks. Selection is done on the basis of merit list. Cutoff list is there. With just one mark, your one mark can decide whether you can become IAS or IPS. One mark can decide a particular designation, particular position. So in these examinations, selection is not based on minimum mark. Here you have to try to cover maximum mark so that you can be included in that cutoff list. Now in traditional exam, minimum efforts are sufficient, whereas in these competitive examinations, maximum efforts are required, because when millions of people are appearing for the examination, if you just for example, let us say 1000 or 10,000 people are appearing for any kind of MPC or UPC examination, and if there are only 10 posts, so automatically it means that including yourself in those final 10 people, you will have to put maximum effort. Then in traditional course examination, there is no competition with others, whereas in competitive examination, you are competing with all the students who are appearing for the same examination. Okay, if 1 lakh students are appearing, so it means that you are competing with 99,999 students. In case of traditional examination, you are not competing with others. You are simply appearing for examination to get that minimum mark, and then you will be able to do it. This is the basic difference. Now, as I said that in traditional examination, for clearing those exams, there may have some kind of shortcut. Okay, I don't suggest that, I don't recommend, but there may have. But in case of competitive examinations, there are no shortcuts at all. There is no shortcut. There is no shortest route by which you will clear competitive examination. There is no such a kind of a remedy by which within minimum efforts you will be able to do it. So that is why our perspective of looking towards traditional examination is entirely different from the perspective of competitive examination. Now, these are some kind of a competitive examinations which I have just listed down. आपके बस जानकारी के लिए मैंने यहाँ पर list किया है. Otherwise, you also may be knowing that. These are the examinations through which we can grab government jobs, that is MPSC, UPSC. These are the very familiar examination through which some can become IAS or IPS. Then IFS is also a separate exam, STI, STO, cell tax officer, cell tax inspector, then PSI, ITO, central excise. Then there is a second graded exam, that is CBI, CID, NDA, CDS, combined defense services. Then there is a third level examinations. If you are not able to compete with the higher examination, then you can appear for lower grade examination, that is PI. PI means that is police inspector, ASI, assistant sub inspector. A lot of vacancies are every year filled by RBI is Reserve Bank of India. Even railways also recruits a lot of employees every year. So there also you will get a lot of exam, and get that. Then TGT, PGT is there, trained graduate teacher, post graduate teacher, especially in case of central government jobs, such kind of examinations are engaged and such kind of examinations are conducted. Then you know that even for becoming Talati or forest guard also, you will have to appear competitive examination. So these are the examinations, especially for government sector. And when you look at the private sector also, some kind of jobs are there, that is bank PO, probationary officer. Even bank clerk, that is clerical grade examination, UDC, upper division clerk, lower division clerk, manager, personal assistant. So all these are the examinations which are cleared through competitive examinations, and there is no shortcut for clearing these competitive examinations. Now the basic question is whether English is really required for for appearing for these examinations or for clearing these examinations. So in just one word, I will say yes. English is really required for passing or clearing these examinations. English is highly necessary for competitive examinations. Okay, and for other things also, for other reasons also, English has become a part and parcel of life. English is essential for communication. English is even essential for whenever you are appearing for job interviews. मान लो कि आपने कैसा तैसा मतलब मैनेज करके आपने एक रिटन एग्जाम क्लरिकल ग्रेड का कर लिया, but when you appear for the interviews, there if the interviewer is asking question in English, so there you cannot say that, sir, I don't know English, just ask me questions in Hindi or Marathi, like that you can't justify yourself. So English is necessary for even job interviews. As we know that today it is the era of technology, and so much of people, so many students and all those, they are having Android mobile phones, laptop and what not, and you know that on internet so much of information is there, but do you know that 80% of information available on internet on various websites is actually in English? Lakhs of web pages are there, but in English language. If you want to access those web pages, if you want to access those information, then you need to understand English. Otherwise, you will simply see. If you want to know information in your own regional language, there might be available, but there is a limitation. Marathi mein aapko har topic ki jankari wahan par internet par nahi milegi, jo jaise aapko English mein keywords dalne se mil sakti hai. So this is the basic difference, because English is all of a language which is used all over the world, and so many people create different websites and lot of resources they are making it available on internet. So that is why 80% information right now which is available on internet is actually in English. Then for other reasons also, whenever you are appearing for online test, English is necessary, and for many more purposes, like English is the main language of books. It is the language of technology, diplomacy, sports, advertising, airports, international communication, international business, trading. So basically English is a global language. It is a language which is spoken throughout the world. It is the library language. Library language means the number of books which are available in English. The highest number of books are available in English, and the number which is available in English, that number, in that number, in no other languages books are available. If you are writing a book and if it becomes bestseller, then for the very first time it will be definitely translated into English. So there is no country in the world, if you visit, you will not, and you will not find any speaker, any listener of English. So that is why English has got such a status today. And in our daily and day-to-day routine life also, if you see that English has become a part and parcel of our life. If you see that in very rural areas, people simply they open very small kind of a shops, but they try to keep the title of their shops in English. छोटे छोटे जो दुकानदार आपने देखा होगा रास्ते पर ऐसे घूमते घूमते, तो वो दुकान भले ही मतलब कोई भी बात की हो, जैसे फुटवेयर का हो या फिर कोई भी चीज का, लेकिन टाइटल वो इंग्लिश में ही रखते हैं. When we visit grocery shops, medical pharmacy shops, so lot of products that we get in our hand, labels which are pasted there, information which is on the product is all in English. So don't think that our regional language is great and we can just work out with that. That is okay. Every language has its own importance and its own significance and weightage is there. But in order to keep pace with the world, agar duniya ke kadam se kadam agar saath mein lekar matlab aapko daudna hai, chalna hai, to you need to know English. Okay, without English nothing will just work out. So answer to this question is simply yes, positively yes, favorably yes, that English is essential. Now, as when we talk about competitive examination, so what kind of attitude or what kind of perspective or what kind of requirement of English is there? So in when we look at all these competitive examinations, either it is a clerical grade exam or MPSC or UPSC, you will find that you will need written English as well as you will need oral English. Now, written English for what purpose? Whenever you are appearing for any kind of exam by RBI, Railways, Bank or MPSC, UPSC, so there definitely in the scrutiny examination, some kind of questions are used in English. These questions are basically on English in order to test your knowledge, basic knowledge, if you have or not. So for dealing with the theory examination, you need to know that written English. And after clearing written examination, कोई bank clerical का या railway का आपने written examination clear कर लिया और आप जब आखिर में interview में जाते हैं, so there for facing the personal interviews, you need to know English. As I said now, that whenever interviewer is asking question, you can't simply switch over. You can't resort to that code switching and changing to your original language. So that is why English is highly essential for from these two perspective. you are written for theory examination also English is essential, as well as for facing interviews your oral English, that is speaking skills, are also essential. Now when we look at the competitive examinations, variety of competitive examinations, you will find that a common pattern, you will find that these are three important sections which I have noted here in the slide. These sections generally appear in various competitive examinations. You will find questions on grammar, you will find questions on vocabulary, you will find questions on comprehension. आप कोई भी छोटी मोटी एग्जाम ले लीजिए, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू आर अपियरिंग फॉर तलाटी एग्जाम और वन रक्षक एग्जाम, फॉरेस्ट गार्ड एग्जाम, यू विल फाइंड दैट सम क्वेश्चंस विल बी प्लेस्ड ऑन ग्रामर, सम विल बी ऑन वोकैबुलरी फॉर टेस्टिंग योर वोकैबुलरी, एंड इवन इन सम एग्जामिनेशंस देयर मे बी क्वेश्चंस ऑन दैट एनालिटिकल कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, एंड अंडर दैट टाइटल मेनी मोर क्वेश्चंस कैन बी देयर. I have discussed these issues in the further slide. So just we have to remember that if you want to really appear for any competitive examination, you will have to focus over these three aspects. One, that is grammar. Second one is vocabulary, and third one is comprehension. So you need to have knowledge of these three things in order to appear, especially in order to deal with the section of English which is there in the competitive examinations which you are going to appear for. Now the questions which are on grammar sections, what do they cover? So grammar par questions hote hai alag alag competitive examinations, isme kaun si cheeze ya kaun se items cover kiye jate hai. So especially questions can be there on related with that part of speech, that is noun, pronoun, adverb, adjective, preposition, like that. Even some in most of the examinations, questions are related with that use of correct tense, use of correct sentences. I will show you in a further slide how these sentences are actually framed.
This is
how
not
these
clear.
Questions. Oh, this is not clear. Just hold on. Hello, am I audible now? Is it
yes,
clear?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. So just as I said in the previous slide, that three in competitive examination question paper, three sections are generally there. I mean, out of these three section, question can be on any one section. There can be a question on grammar sections. There can be questions on vocabulary or on that comprehension. Like that. So the questions which are on grammar section, they cover generally these topics, that is part of speech, and generally they cover the error detection in sentences, that is tense part, which is of that grammar. Now when we look at vocabulary section, so questions which are which we find in different competitive examinations, they are generally related with homonyms, synonyms and antonyms. Synonyms and antonyms is a quite familiar term, you as we have studied in your previous syllabuses also. Samanarthi shabd aur virudharthi shabd jo hote hain uske char options diye jate hain, and then you will have to pick up the right alternative. Okay, questions are related with that root words, this I will explain in the further slide. Idioms and proverbs, there can be questions on related with that idioms and proverbs. One sentence is given and you will have to you will have to replace a particular part of the that question by using idiom, a suitable idiom or suitable proverb. Then questions are there on closed test, then one word substitutions. This is the closed test one word substitution. What kind of questions are there, that I will try to show in my slide. Okay, questions can be there on appropriate spellings of words. Okay, same words, wrong spelling, incorrect spelling will be put in four multiple objectives, alternatives, and you will have to correct, you will have to choose the correct spelling, correct alternative of a particular words. So this is just designed to test how proficient you are in English language. Then questions are there on phrase replacement also. So these are the areas which are generally covered under vocabulary section in various competitive examination. Okay, Then in the last section, that is comprehension and verbal ability. So here the questions are based on scheme reading, scanning, sentence jumble, paragraph jumble, theme based questions are there, and close test is there. I will explain these some of these concept in the further slide, because unless and until we understand what exact these items are, we may not be prepared for, and we may not be able to go through it. So overall, if you see these three sections, and I have also seen the syllabus which is used for different kind of competitive examinations. So I just found that these are the common recurring topics which are repeatedly used for putting questions in various competitive examinations. Generally, the questions are on error detection in a given sentence, then analytical comprehension of paragraph. This is quite familiar with you because you have already faced such kind of questions. Then questions related with that vocabulary, that is as I just now I said, related with that synonyms, antonyms, word substitute, clause test, etc. Rearrangement of sequencing of sentence, that is jumbling of paragraph and jumbling of sentences are there. And then questions related with that usage of language items like articles, preposition, and subject verb agreement, that is concord. So these are the common topics which you will find if you see the question papers of various competitive examinations. So out of these six topics, at least there will be questions on 2-3 topics in one exam, on 2-3 topics in another exam. So such kind of things are there. Now if you look at the banking PO syllabus, that is probationary officer syllabus, so you will find that this is the syllabus which is framed for banking examination. Even for preliminary examination also same kind of syllabus is given, and for mains exam also same has been used. Now questions are there on reasoning ability, general intelligence. These are five sections: quantitative aptitude, data interpretation, general and banking awareness, and then one section is there, that is English language objective and descriptive. So in banking examination, there is one particular section, I mean some questions are put on English language, especially objective part of the English language as well as descriptive part of English language. Now these descriptive part questions are generally put in the mains examination of probationary officer. Okay, now this is what the division and weightage of marks in banking sector. When you are appearing for any examination of banking sector, you will find that such is the division of marks or weightage of marks. English language is carrying 30 questions and they have that 30 marks, and you get 20 minutes. Reasoning section, 35 questions, 35 marks, 20 minutes are allotted for that. Numerical ability is also having same weightage. So it makes these three sections make actually paper of 100 marks. Okay, 60 minutes paper when you are appearing for bank clerical grade or bank PO examination. So 1 hour examination is there, that is preliminary exam, and there you will find that your 30% weightage is on English language. Now when you, after clearing this preliminary exam, if you are luckily appearing for mains exam, in the mains exam also you will find that 35 questions are there on English language and 40 marks it is carrying, I mean weightage of 40 marks is there, 35 questions are there in the mains examination. Now these are some five questions which I have just designed here. If you really want to know that what kind of language sense you have, or whether what is your language competence, whatever language that we have learned so far, abhi tak aapne jo kuch bhasha seekhi hai abhi tak itne pichle 10-12 saal mein 15-20 saal mein, to what kind of language you have picked up, what kind of vocabulary you have picked up, and whether you can feel whether you can use a suitable words in these sentences. So these are just a sample question. Just go through the question and try to find out suitable alternative for the blank. In every sentence I have kept a blank. Sabhi 5 sentence mein ek jagah par blank, aur wo blank mein aapko ek suitable word dalne se wo sentence meaningful ban jayega. तो अगर आपको ये पांचों के पांच सेंटेंस में आपको एक सुटेबल वर्ड अगर दिखता है, मतलब अलग अलग सेंटेंस में अलग अलग वर्ड्स है, तो आप समझ लीजिए कि आपका लैंग्वेज सेंस अच्छा है. लेट अस रीड द सेंटेंस. आई हैव बीन ब्लैंक फॉर यू एवरीवेयर. Now here in the blank you will have to use one suitable word by which the entire sentence will become meaningful. Since he was blank, he went to doctor for consultation. Third sentence is the car blank climbed the steep slope because it was in the wrong gear. Fourth sentence is the Indian Independence Day is blank on 15th August every year. So what word you will use this blank by which this sentence will become grammatically and cement linguistically meaningful and complete one. My friend advised me to opt commerce, but I didn't listen his blank. So you will have to use one appropriate word at the end by which this fifth sentence also becomes meaningful. So just think of the suitable words which you will use in this blank, and if you are able to fill up with the suitable words, and if they are correct one, just assume that you have a good vocabulary and you have good language sense. Okay, so these are the answers. I have been looking for you everywhere. Since he was ill, or you can say unwell, he went to doctor for consultation. You cannot use any other word in this blank by which the sentence can become meaningful. The car couldn't climb the steep slope. Now why couldn't? Because the another clause is actually in past tense. So you can't say here, doesn't, or you can't say here don't. Okay, you will have to use here couldn't, because could shows capacity, could shows ability. Okay, so that is why here you will have to use that word couldn't. Indian Independence Day is celebrated on 15th August every year. Can use held also, but more suitable word. You will find that one more thing in the various competitive examinations. I will show you sample closed question. There all the options which are given are near to each other, but you will have to use the most suitable one. एक क्लोज टेस्ट नाम का सेक्शन होता है बहुत सारे कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जामिनेशंस में, जिसमें आपको चार जो ऑप्शन दिए रहते हैं वो चारों वर्ड्स आपको ठीक ठाक ही लगते हैं, लेकिन उसमें से सबसे ज्यादा जो सुटेबल होता है, द मोस्ट सुटेबल इज द करेक्ट आंसर, एंड दैट इज व्हाई यू विल हैव टू यूज मोस्ट सुटेबल वर्ड्स, एंड फॉर दैट पर्पज यू विल हैव टू एनहांस योर वोकैबुलरी. ओके, दिस वाज जस्ट अ काइंड ऑफ लैंग्वेज सेंस टेस्ट. नाउ लेट अस कम टू the real questions which are there on some particular sections. Okay, I told you what are the common topic in the previous slides, and now I will just discuss that what are the questions in these particular section. For example, this section, error detection in statement, this is a kind of a topic which is included in the competitive examinations, and here such kind of questions are kept. One statement, 4 to 5 fragments are given, and you will have to find out error, in which part that error is there. 4-5 हिस्से दिए हैं sentence के, अलग अलग किए हैं A, B, C, D, ऐसे कौन से हिस्से में error है, तो जो error वाला portion है वो आपको identify करना होता है. My sisters in law who live in Bangalore have come to stay with us. Last part is no error, because in some sentences deliberately no error is kept, so for that sentences no error is the correct choice. So now just to find out what is the suitable option, I mean what is the correct part, I mean in which part you will find the error, kaun se hisse mein aapko error dikhta hai, grammatical error or syntactical error or linguistic error, whatever. So dusra ek question niche maine diya hai, transporting goods by air is cheaper than land. This is very short sentence. So here there are only 4 sections are there. Transporting goods by, first section, air is cheaper, second section, than land, third section, no error, fourth section. That is, these are the 4 alternatives you can assume, and you will have to tick mark, or you will have to choose the correct alternative where error is there. Okay, so these are the answers. In the first sentence, my sisters in law, this is grammatically wrong. We don't say sisters in law, we have to say sister in law. if there are more than one, then you can make plural by adding s in law. That is, you can say sister-in-laws, brother-in-laws, father-in-laws, like that. Okay, the plural is not used in these words, that is sister, brother, father, etc. So this part is incorrect. This is the correct option. And then in the next sentence, this one, that is transporting goods by air is cheaper than land. So than land is actually incorrect part. Okay, here it should be by air. Just as by air is there, so here it should be by land, not than land. So than land is incorrect portion. Okay, so such kind of questions are there under category of error detection in sentences. Now closed test, in the previous slides I told you that closed test is also one of the item, one of the topic which is prescribed or which is included in the most of the question papers of competitive examination. So what exactly is a closed test? So it is nothing but a kind of a fill in the blank, okay, where the some words are omitted actually, and you have to fill the blank with suitable words either grammatically or context wise. Just like previous sentences, some kind of blanks are provided, and in these blank you will have to find out a suitable word to fill it in that blank. And these questions are of two type. ये closed test में जो जितने भी questions आते हैं वो दो categories में होते हैं. One which is given in the form of filling in the blanks, and second is the other one is where incorrect words have to be replaced. Okay, so such kind of questions are there in that closed test. This is one sample. Look at the sentence. Only one question I have put here just for your understanding. Earth has a unique place in our galaxy. क्लोज टेस्ट में किस प्रकार के क्वेश्चन होते हैं ये एक सैंपल से आपको ध्यान में आ सकता है. जस्ट रीड द क्वेश्चन. अर्थ हैज अ यूनिक प्लेस इन अवर गैलेक्सी. इट इज द ओनली ब्लैंक. यहाँ पर ब्लैंक दिया है. यू विल हैव टू यूज योर सुटेबल वर्ड. ओके, सो इट इज द ओनली ब्लैंक नोन टू हैव एन एटमोस्फियर कंटेनिंग फ्री ऑक्सीजन, ओशंस ऑफ वॉटर ऑन इट्स सर्फेस, एंड ऑफकोर्स लाइफ. सो दिस इज द पर्टिकुलर क्वेश्चन which comes under category of that closed test, and you will have to use here one of the option. Five options are given here: satellite, planet, moon, surface and life. So inme se kaun sa option, kaun sa word yahan par use karne se it will become completely meaningful, it will become absolutely meaningful. So you just think and then you will find. Now you can just try every word just to check out or confirm whether the option is correct or not. If you are using the word satellite, it is the only satellite. No, Earth is not a satellite. It is the only planet. Yeah, it can be correct. But let us try other option. It is the only moon. No, Earth is not moon. It is the only surface. No, it is the only life. No. So some options are logically incorrect. Some options are linguistically incorrect. So the correct option which is the most suitable is that is B, planet. Now if you are putting the word here planet, sentence will become: Earth has a unique place in our galaxy. It is the only planet known to have an atmosphere containing free oxygen. So out of the five words, planet is the most suitable words. Then the questions on homonyms. Now homonyms, you may be unfamiliar with the term. Homonyms are the words that have same pronunciation but different spelling and meaning. Now you might have found that some words they have same kind of pronunciation. So when you utter these words, same kind of sound comes, but actually the meaning and spelling of these words is different. Okay, now you see just in example, your perfume has a wonderful. Now here blank is kept. Now three options are given: scent, scent, scent. अब ये सेंट 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 ये तीनों ए बी सी जो ऑप्शन दिख रहे हैं, तीनों का उच्चारण करते समय साउंड जो है वो एक जैसा ही आ रहा है, लेकिन इनकी स्पेलिंग और इनका मीनिंग जो है वो अलग अलग है. एस सी ई एन टी सेंट का मीनिंग अलग है. एस ई एन टी सेंट इज ए पास्ट टेंस ऑफ सेंट. देन सी ई एन टी सेंट इज ऑल्सो डिफरेंट. सो सच काइंड ऑफ सिमिलर सच काइंड ऑफ वर्ड्स हैविंग सिमिलर साउंड, सिमिलर प्रोनाउंसिएशन बट हैविंग मीनिंग डिफरेंट, such kind of words are called as homonyms. Okay, homophones or homonym. So So what will be the correct option here? Your perfume has a wonderful. आप कौन सा वर्ड डालने से सेंटेंस मीनिंगफुल बनेगा? आपने ये बी वाला एसीएनटी सेंट लगा दिया तो ये सेंटेंस मीनिंगफुल नहीं बनेगा. ओके, क्योंकि ये पास से सेंट का यहाँ पर बिल्कुल सुटेबल नहीं है. सीएनटी सेंट लगाने से भी नहीं, क्योंकि सीएनटी सेंट का मतलब होता है चिल्लर पैसे, यानी कि 100 सेंट का एक डॉलर बनता है. ओके, जैसे हमारे यहाँ कॉइन्स होते हैं ना, तो ठीक वैसे ही इन यूरोपियन कंट्रीज जो चिल्लर पैसे होते हैं उनको सेंट कहा जाता है. तो ये भी यहाँ पर सुटेबल नहीं. सो थर्ड राइट ऑप्शन इज दैट इज एस सी ई एन टी सेंट. ये सेंट का मतलब होता है खुशबू. ओके, योर परफ्यूम हैज ए वंडरफुल सेंट. सो दैट सेंट इज एक्चुअली एस सी ई एन टी. सो दिस इज मोस्ट सुटेबल. वन मोर क्वेश्चन इज देयर. आई बैंगड माई ब्लैंक ऑन द लेग ऑफ द टेबल. सो वट विल यू यूज हियर? टी ओ डब्ल्यू टो और टी ओ ई टो, दोनों का प्रोनाउंसिएशन एक जैसा है लेकिन मीनिंग अलग है. टी ओ डब्ल्यू टो का मतलब होता है जोड़ना, बांधना, एक चीज को दूसरे चीज से बांधना. जैसे गाड़ियों को टो किया जाता है. ओके, इफ यू आर हैविंग सम टेक्निकल डिफिकल्टी इन योर कार ऑन रोड एंड देन यू कॉल द टोविंग सर्विसेज एंड देन दे जस्ट टो योर कार, आपकी कार को रास्ते पर जो खराब होगी उसको टो करके लेके जाते हैं. तो टो का मतलब होता है बांधना, कनेक्ट करना. टीओई टो का मतलब होता है आपके पैर की एड़ी का आगे का हिस्सा. तो विच वर्ड इज सुटेबल हियर? आई बैंगड माई टो ऑन द लेग ऑफ द टेबल. तो यहाँ पर फर्स्ट वाला जो टी ओ डब्ल्यू टो है ये सुटेबल नहीं है. यहाँ पर टी ओ ई टो चाहिए, पैर के एड़ी का हिस्सा. मैंने पैर के एड़ी के हिस्से को टेबल के पैर को मार दिया. ओके, तो दिस सच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चंस कम अंडर कैटेगरी ऑफ दैट होमोनिम. देन जंबल्ड सेंटेंसेस आर देयर. कट हियर, सेंटेंसेस आर देयर एंड यू विल हैव टू यूज दिस फोर सेंटेंसेस इन करेक्ट ऑर्डर. तो उसका करेक्ट ऑर्डर क्या होगा? फोर ऑप्शंस आर गिवन. ओके, यहाँ पर देखो ऑप्शन जो दिया है 4, 2, 5, 1, 3, मतलब फोर्थ सेंटेंस फर्स्ट, देन सेकंड सेंटेंस लेटर, देन फिफ्थ सेंटेंस लाइक दैट. सो व्हाट विल बी द करेक्ट ऑर्डर? ये पूरे सेंटेंसेस करेक्ट ऑर्डर में कैसे रहेंगे, इसका करेक्ट ऑर्डर कौन सा है? तो करेक्ट ऑर्डर ये है 3, 1, 5, 2, 4, क्योंकि यहाँ से सेंटेंस की शुरुआत हो रही. मतलब ये फर्स्ट सेंटेंस में हम लोग नाउन को इंट्रोड्यूस करते. ओके, और बाकी उसी टॉपिक के बारे में अगर सेकंड एंड थर्ड सेंटेंस में कहना है तो हम लोग प्रोनाउन के बारे में यूज करते हैं. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू वांट टू टॉक ऑन महात्मा गांधी, सो इन एवरी सेंटेंस यू विल नॉट रिपीट महात्मा गांधी. ओके, इन फर्स्ट सेंटेंस यू विल से महात्मा गांधी वॉज अ ग्रेट लीडर, देन इन सेकेंड सेंटेंस यू विल से ही. ओके, सो इट इज जस्ट लाइक दैट. तो ये लॉजिक आपको लगाना है यहाँ पर, कि यहाँ पर सबसे पहले सब्जेक्ट जो है वो टॉपिक यहाँ पर नाउन फॉर्म में यूज किया है, बाकी जगह पर प्रोनाउन यूज किया है. तो 3, 1, 5, 2, 4 ये राइट सीक्वेंस है. ओके, जंबल सेंटेंसेस, इनको थीम बेस्ड क्वेश्चन भी कहते हैं. थीम बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस भी एग्जैक्टली इसके जैसे ही होते हैं. सेकंड ऑप्शन इज आल्सो गिवन हियर. यहाँ पर देखिए 4-5 वर्ड्स है, लेफ्ट, दी, हाउस, ही, सडनली, एंड यू विल हैव टू मेक ए सुटेबल मीनिंगफुल सेंटेंस बाई प्लेसिंग ऑल दीज वर्ड्स इन ए राइट ऑर्डर. ये पांचों वर्ड्स को एक अप्रोप्रिएट ऑर्डर में रखकर मीनिंगफुल सेंटेंस बनाना है. तो सेंटेंस मीनिंगफुल बनाने के लिए सबसे पहले आपको सब्जेक्ट चाहिए. सब्जेक्ट ये डी के ऑप्शन में है, ही. तो यही से आपका मतलब ये आंसर शुरू हो सकता है, क्योंकि दूसरा कोई ऑप्शन ही नहीं है ही से शुरू होने वाला. ही सडनली लेफ्ट द हाउस. सो दिस इज द प्रॉपर ऑर्डर ऑफ द गिवन सेंटेंस. So such kind of questions are there under category of that jumbled sentences. One word substitution, already you are familiar with this kind of item because of this particular thing has been prescribed in the syllabus of BA first year and in second year also. काफी सारे मतलब exams में आपने इसको पहले attempt किया होगा. You will have to find out one particular word which can replace all the words given. A picture of a person or a thing drawn in such a Hold on. Yeah. Okay. Now you see, a picture of a person or a thing drawn in such a highly exaggerated manner as to cause laughter. अब ये पूरे सभी words में जो बात कही है वो उसके लिए कौन सा एक ही वर्ड सुटेबल है, किसी भी व्यक्ति का कोई एक पिक्चर जिसमें उस व्यक्ति का हंसी आने लायक एग्जैगरेशन किया जाता है, ओके, तो उसको कहा जाता है कैरिकेचर, ओके, इट इज नॉट ए कार्टून, इट इज नॉट ए कैकोग्राफी, इट इज नॉट ए कार्टोग्राफी, इट इज कैरिकेचर। जैसे आप व्यंग्य चित्र जिसको बोलते हैं ना, किसी व्यक्ति का व्यंग्य चित्र ऐसे निकाला जाता है जिससे कि हंसी आती है, तो उसको उसको कैरिकेचर कहते हैं, ओके। दैट विच कैन नॉट बी कॉल्ड बैक, जो कोई सो चीज अंडू नहीं हो सकती, जो अंडन नहीं हो सकता, ऐसी चीजों को क्या बोलेंगे, उसको इररिस्पॉन्सिबल बोलेंगे, इररिवोकेबल बोलेंगे, इररिडेमेबल या इनकैलकुलेबल। सो राइट ऑप्शन इज एक्चुअली इररिवोकेबल। ये वोकैबुलरी से रिलेटेड वन वर्ड सब्स्टिट्यूशन के क्वेश्चन इसी प्रकार से होते हैं। ऑल द वर्ड्स विच आर गिवन दे आर सीमिंगली नियर टू ईच अदर, बट यू विल हैव टू फाइंड आउट द मोस्ट सुटेबल वन, ओके। Not able to go to next slide. Slide operate nahi ho rahi. Okay. So there is one more topic, that is root words. Root words is, root word means what? Root word is actually a word that becomes a basis of new words by adding affixes, that is prefix or suffix. In language, so many words are there. But all these words are not independent. Lot of words are there which are formed by using a root of another word. एक root word होता है, एक basic हिस्सा होता है word का, और उसके आगे में या पीछे में suffix या prefix लगाने से दूसरे कई सारे words बनते हैं। जैसे go, go के go go word से कई सारे words बनते हैं, goes, going, forego, undergo। कुछ आपने पहले लगा दिया, कुछ बाद में लगा दिया, तो पहले लगाया उसको prefix कहते हैं, बाद में लगाया उसको सफिक्स कहते हैं, ओके। तो ऐसे वर्ड्स बनते हैं, लेकिन रूट पार्ट क्या है, जी ओ गो, ठीक वैसे ही इससे रिलेटेड पार्ट पर भी क्वेश्चंस होते हैं कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जामिनेशंस में। जैसे हियर आई हैव जस्ट गिवन वन एग्जांपल, सी आई डी ई साइड, ये एक लैटिन वर्ड है जो रूट वर्ड है। अब इससे मिलकर कई सारे वर्ड्स बनते हैं, जैसे पैट्रिसाइड, यूक्सोरिसाइड, मेरिट्रिसाइड, इन्फेंटिसाइड। सो दीज आर मेनी मोर वर्ड्स दैट बिकम बिकॉज ऑफ दैट साइड। ठीक वैसे ही लॉजी, एंटी, फोबिया, ये भी रूट वर्ड्स है, ओके। एंटी सोशल, एंटीसेप्टिक, एंटी इन्फ्लेमेटरी, तो कई सारे वर्ड्स एंटी वर्ड लगाकर बनते हैं, ओके। सो दीज आर कॉल्ड एज रूट वर्ड्स। इनके ऊपर जो क्वेश्चंस होते हैं वो इस प्रकार के होते हैं, व्हाट आर द रूट वर्ड्स एंड सफिक्सेस फॉर वर्ड रिमार्केबल। रिमार्केबल वर्ड के लिए रूट वर्ड क्या है और सफिक्स क्या है, ये आपको आइडेंटिफाई करना है। फोर ऑप्शंस आर गिवन। Now, out of these four options, this first, second, fourth option, these are not the correct option. Third one is the correct option. क्योंकि इसमें original word है remark, और जो suffix लगाया गया है वो A, B, L, E, ये suffix है. Remarkable, calculable, permissible. So like that we add suffixes. So such kind of questions are there on. So here we have taken an overview of some kind of questions which generally you find in various competitive examinations. So what are the ways to cope up with these competitive examination questions if you are appearing for any kind of competitive examinations, and if you want to really clear or go through any examination, so what strategy you will adopt? As I said, there are no shortcuts. You will have to, only two ways are there. First thing is try to learn the nuances of English. जो इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज की जो बारकाइयां है वो सीखे, इंग्लिश जो बेसिक्स ऑफ ग्रामर है वो अच्छे से मतलब आप करें, वोकैबुलरी बढ़ाने के लिए कोशिश करें, कुछ अच्छा पढ़ते रहे, सुनते रहे। सो लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दैट यू विल हैव टू डू, सो लर्न द नुआंसेस ऑफ इंग्लिश। सेकेंड थिंग इज प्रैक्टिस इन रिटन एंड ओरल फॉर्म। अनलेस यू प्रैक्टिस इन रिटन फॉर्म, यूर राइटिंग स्किल्स विल नॉट बी डेवलप्ड, एंड अनलेस यू प्रैक्टिस इन ओरल फॉर्म यू मे नॉट बी एबल टू स्पीक। जब तक आप ओरल फॉर्म में उसको प्रैक्टिस नहीं करेंगे, आपका कम्युनिकेशन लेवल, कम्युनिकेशन जो कॉम्पिटेंस है वो नहीं बढ़ेगा। तो आपका राइटिंग स्किल, ओरल स्पीकिंग स्किल, ये भी आपको ध्यान देना है, इसको भी एनहांस करना है, इसको डेवलप करना है, शार्पन करना है। और दूसरी बात, आपको लैंग्वेज के जो नुआंसेस है, बारकाइयां, वो सीखनी है, ओके। दीज आर सम स्ट्रेटजीज। आई एम कमिंग टू द कंक्लूजन ऑफ माई प्रेजेंटेशन, दिस इज जस्ट द लास्ट व्हाट वी कैन से स्लाइड। So these are some things which I have mentioned here that you can take care of. Read newspapers daily. कुछ अखबार इंग्लिश में जो अखबार होते हैं वो उसको डेली पढ़ने की आप हैबिट लगाइए, जस्ट रीड देम, बिकॉज न्यूज़पेपर आई कंसिडर दे आर द मोस्ट दे आर द आइटम्स वेयर प्रैग्मेटिक लैंग्वेज, प्रैक्टिकल लैंग्वेज इज यूज. आप जिस प्रकार की प्रैक्टिकल लैंग्वेज में बात करते हैं ठीक वैसे ही प्रैक्टिकल लैंग्वेज अखबार में यूज की जाती है. यू विल फाइंड दैट द वर्ब्स एस्पेशली द वर्ड्स विच आर यूज इन द न्यूज आइटम दे आर दीज वर्ड्स आर हाईली यूजफुल फॉर इम्प्रूविंग अवर वोकैबुलरी. ओके, बिकॉज वेन यू आर रीडिंग ए बुक लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल फिक्शन और नॉन फिक्शन, सो दे आर यू विल फाइंड सम काइंड ऑफ लिटरेरी वर्ड्स, बट वेन यू रीड ए पर्टिकुलर न्यूज on accident, news on any kind of thing, so they are practically or pragmatically useful vocabulary or useful words you will find. So read newspapers daily, then build your vocabulary. Vocabulary doesn't develop automatically. Vocabulary aisi cheez hai ki jo apne aap matlab raat mein wo overnight mein develop nahi hoti, iske liye aapko alag se koshishe karni hoti hai, usi ke liye textbook hote hain. Lekin hamari problem ye hai ki students generally do not purchase textbook, they simply go for purchasing the digest, and when we repeatedly ask them to purchase textbook, even then they do not pay attention to that. So actually textbooks are there to increase, to enhance your vocabulary. वो जो लेसन दिया है किसी राइटर का उसमें अगर कहानी है तो वो कहानी पढ़ लेने से आपके जीवन में कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला. उसमें जो वर्ड्स दिए हैं, जो सेंटेंस का ऑर्डर दिया है, जो पैटर्न दिया है वो समझना है, नए वर्ड्स को ढूंढना है. सो दैट इज वाई वोकैबुलरी ऐसे बढ़ेगी व्हेन यू रीड ए पर्टिकुलर न्यू सेक्शन, न्यू लेसन, न्यू पोयम. सो देयर यू फाइंड आउट न्यू वर्ड्स एंड इन दिस वे यू जस्ट गो ऑन एडिंग वर्ड्स इन यूर वोकैबुलरी. स्ट्रेंथन द बेसिक्स ऑफ ग्रामर. If you are thinking of going for competitive examination, then you must know the basics of grammar, because in almost every examination you will find that questions are placed on grammar sections, vocabulary sections like that. So aapka grammar ka jo hissa hai wo bilkul thoda sa clear chahiye, yani kuch jo basic cheeze hai you must be very much familiar with that. Okay, possess sharp listening skills. If you want to become a good speaker, अगर आपको अच्छा इंग्लिश में बोलना है या बात करना है, ये सीखना है, बोलना सीखना है, तो पहले सुनना सीखिए. Listen to good speakers every day. Now this, you are actually born and you are living in a very good era where you have gadgets like Android mobile phones, laptop and many more things, and so many resources are there on your mobile, on internet. You can take help of that. So you can listen various YouTube videos, various speeches, various kind of webinars, and through listening you can pick up the language. Through listening you come to know what are the right pronunciation and how is the proper way of speaking. So listening actually helps to improve our language. Then last thing that I would like to say, that inculcate the habit of speaking and writing, because speaking and writing will not come simply by reading. It is a matter of practice. Unless and until you try to speak, unless and until you try to write, so these skills will not be sharpened. जब तक आप कुछ खुद बोलने की कोशिश नहीं करेंगे, जब तक आप लिखने की कोशिश नहीं करेंगे, तब तक आपका स्पीकिंग और राइटिंग का जो स्किल है वो नहीं बढ़ेगा. ओके, तो अपने दोस्तों के साथ में आपका वट एवर द ग्रुप दैट यू हैव फॉर्म, ट्राई टू स्पीक विद देम. अगर आपको एम्बरासमेंट लगता है दोस्तों के सामने बोलने में, तो सिंपल आइडिया मैं आपको बताता हूँ कि जैसे हम लोग शांत होते हैं और हम लोग मराठी या हिंदी में सोचते हैं मन में कि कल मुझे यहाँ जाना है, कल मुझे वो करना है, कल मुझे ऐसा करना है, तो यही जो सोच है आप मराठी में या हिंदी में रीजनल लैंग्वेज में सोचने के बजाय आप इंग्लिश में सोचना शुरू करें. टुमारो आई हैव टू गेट अप एट 6 o'clock, देन आई हैव टू गो टू कॉलेज, देन आई हैव टू मीट मिस्टर एक्स, देन आई हैव टू डू दिस, देन आई हैव टू डू दैट, सो लाइक दैट. सो यू, इट इज जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ प्रैक्टिस. सो वंस यू स्टार्ट थिंकिंग इन इंग्लिश ऑटोमेटिकली, बिकॉज देर इज नोबडी टू सी, वहां पर कोई नहीं आपको क्या सोच रहे हैं ये बोलने वाला, आपको टोकने वाला या आपको गलतियां निकालने वाला, तो इससे आपका जो बोलने का जो मतलब स्पीकिंग स्किल है ये बेहतर हो सकता है. दिस इज वन ऑफ द प्रैक्टिकल स्ट्रेटजी टू इम्प्रूव अवर स्पीकिंग स्किल. नाउ देयर आर सम रिसोर्सेस अवेलेबल ऑन इंटरनेट इफ यू रियली वॉन्ट टू अपियर फॉर एनी कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जामिनेशन इन फ्यूचर. सो लॉट ऑफ बुक्स आर देयर विच आर अवेलेबल. Now there is thousands of resources are available. So these are some of the books which I have just noted here: English for You, Grammar Teacher, Oxford Guide to English Grammar, English Page Online. So these are some of the books which I have just noted here. Then there are some YouTube channels also. Nowadays there is a craze for watching the YouTube channel for each and every aspect which we do not understand. तो आप बाकी की फालतू चीजें YouTube पर देखने के बजाय आप इंग्लिश कैसे बोलना सीखे, कैसे मतलब अपनी वोकैबुलरी बढ़ाए, इससे रिलेटेड कई सारे वीडियोज है, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ वीडियोज आर अवेलेबल एंड एवरी डे लॉट ऑफ एडिशंस आर देयर. सो यू जस्ट गो फॉर YouTube चैनल्स. दिस फोर YouTube चैनल्स विच आई हैव नोटेड हियर, इंग्लिश पॉइंट, Wi-Fi study, dear sir, and competitive English. Apart from that, lot of numerous YouTube channels are also available, which you can take help of. Some of the books are also there. Lot of books you will find even in PDF form and e-book form on the internet. But these books just I have noted. Objective Grammar English ये एक अग्रवाल की किताब है, ये आपको मतलब काफी सहायता करती है. English for Bank Exam, Objective General English. डिस्क्रिप्टिंग इंग्लिश ग्रामर के लिए आप रेन एंड मार्टिन का भी इंग्लिश ग्रामर का टेक्स्ट बुक यूज कर सकते हैं. सो थाउजेंड्स ऑफ बुक्स आर अवेलेबल. वट इज नीडेड इज दैट वी मस्ट हैव अवर मेंटल रेडीनेस, वी मस्ट बी रेडी टू पुट अवर हार्ड एफर्ट्स एंड वी मस्ट बी अस्पायर्ड फॉर ए पर्टिकुलर टारगेट. जब तक हमारे मन में कोई मतलब ऐसा टारगेट डिवेलप नहीं होता है, जब तक हम लोग ठान नहीं लेते कि हमें ये करना है, तो तब तक नहीं होता है. ओके, सो आई थिंक दिस विल बी सफिशियंट. And the kind of opportunity that Dr. Ujade sir and the principal Dr. Bakre sir has given to me to just share a few ideas, because I don't think myself as a very much expert in this particular field, but I'm a teacher and we generally deliver these topics for our students also. So I thought that this would be beneficial to you. So this is all for today, guys. So thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to interact with you. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Sanjay Shende sir. Thank you so much. This was a wonderful presentation in front of our students and us. If some students are willing to ask any sort of a question, they are free to ask to the resource person. If someone is willing to ask question,
yes, sure. Welcome.
Do you want to know anything from our resource person, Dr. Shende sir? Okay, if it is not possible for you,
sir, there is one question in our group,
yes,
WhatsApp
sir.
Group for yeah. Sanjay Shende sir. So yeah. The question is, what should be done to improve our vocabulary, and are there some of the books like novels and dramas which are in simple language which are available, and will they improve vocabulary after reading novels and dramas? So actually there are so many, but if there are in simple language, student can read them. Sir,
yes,
please
yes.
suggest some of the books.
Definitely. Now you see, sir, vocabulary development is also, as I said, it cannot be done overnight. But if we make some specific and deliberate attempts, we can definitely improve our vocabulary. One more thing I would like to tell you, that everybody has some kind of vocabulary of English language. We are not what we can say a novice to English language, because if I say a keyword to you, hospital, so you will say a lot of words related to hospital. Okay, so we know that a word related to hospital is nurses, operation theater, doctor. Okay, so our vocabulary, everybody is having some kind of vocabulary. What is needed is to improve it by making some additions. Now second thing, how to improve. So lot of books are there, especially some books are related with vocabulary. On internet also these books are available, and on pdf.com there also you will find free PDF books are also available there. And third part of your question was, which novels you would like to suggest which are helpful in improving our English. Now if you see, if you are switching over to a very great writer, you will find that at every occasion you will try to look up in the dictionary. I will suggest a writer, by reading his novels you will find that you will be able to easily understand them. R.K. Narayan is an Indian novelist, and he has a lot of novels, that is Mr. Sampath, Swami and Friends, My Life, My Days, sorry, his autobiography. So these are some of the novels, and when you read these novels, no, you will find that his English is very simple. But if you are reading the novels of Arundhati Roy or that any other Indian writer, you will find it little bit complicated to understand. Now, one more thing I will just add here by for just enhancing or improving our vocabulary. One more practice you can do, which I did in my life when I was a student of PG. What I used to do, every day I used to take 5 new words from the dictionary, and then I used to write them on the paper. And I used to remember, I used to memorize them, their meaning, their connotations, their denotations, and whatever. And at the end of the day, I used to paste that paper on a particular tag. So in this way, every day, if you are making yourself familiar with 5 new words, already you have some kind of words. Okay, when we understand somebody speaking, it means that we have a good vocabulary. But in order to improve our vocabulary, we have to add. We have to keep on adding. For addition, you can do this tactic that you can add new 5 words every day, memorize them, read them, try to understand them, and try to use them in your language. One more thing I would suggest for improving vocabulary, just read daily newspapers. Simple newspapers like that Hitwad and Indian Express. Don't go for that Times of India and the Tribune or that Sun, etc. on international level, because by reading them, you will simply be baffled and confused what exactly they mean. So just try to read every day 2-3 article or as much as possible. Just half an hour you spent while reading that Hitwad, you will come to know that in newspaper, highly pragmatic language is used, highly practical language is used. So whatever the words that we do not know for particular parallel Marathi or Hindi words, there while reading the news, you will come to know. So reading newspapers is the biggest and the most useful strategy for improving our vocabulary. So this is all, lot of efforts we can do, but these are some strategies which I suggest to my students also for improving our vocabulary.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. I ask one question, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I can talk in Marathi, sir.
Okay. Salel.
Yes, yes. Sir,
सगळे जण आम्ही म्हणजे बीए बीएचे स्टूडेंट आहोत सर. म्हणजे मी बीएचे स्टूडेंट आहे. सर म्हणजे जेव्हा आपण एमपीएससीचे प्रिपरेशन करत असतो सर, तेव्हा म्हणजे पहिले इंग्लिशला आपण थोडा घाबरतो सर. म्हणजे खूप इझी लँग्वेज आहे सर, बट आपण घाबरतो. तर फर्स्टली आपण काय म्हणजे रीड करू शकतो की त्यामुळे आपल्याला थोडस सोपं वाटेल.
नाव जर तुम्हाला एमपीएससी सारखी एक्झाम पास करणे हे तुम्ही तुमचं ध्येय ठरवलेले असेल आणि तुम्ही तिथे क्वेश्चन पेपर पाहिला आणि पेपर पॅटर्न पाहिला, तर तुम्हाला तिथे थोडस कन्फ्युजन होऊ शकतं. कारण तिथे तुम्हाला एक चांगल्या लेवलची इंग्लिशची अपेक्षा आहे. पण तसं करण्याच्या पूर्वी तुम्ही आधी स्वतःकडे पाहून तुमची इंग्लिश खरोखर किती आहे त्यानुसार तुम्ही स्वतःची आखणी केली पाहिजे, तयारी केली पाहिजे. सगळ्यात महत्त्वाची गोष्ट, मी जसं माझ्या प्रेझेंटेशन दरम्यान सुद्धा सांगितलं की आपण जो फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रॅमर आहे ते आपण समजून घेतले पाहिजे. बेसिक्स ऑफ ग्रॅमर जे आहे, जसं पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच आहे, नॅरेशन आहे, व्हॉइस आहे, ह्या ज्या काही गोष्टी आहेत त्या आपण आधी समजून घेतल्या पाहिजे. थोड्या ह्या समजून आल्यानंतर आपण मग इतर पार्टकडे आपण स्वतः वळू शकतो. जसं कॉम्प्रिहेन्शनचा पार्ट आहे, प्रेसिज रायटिंग आहे, एसे रायटिंग आहे, तर आपल्याला अशा प्रकारे हळूवार स्टेप बाय स्टेप आपल्याला जाता येईल. समजा तुमचा लँग्वेज सेन्स किंवा तुमची लँग्वेज एकदम कमजोर असेल आणि तुम्ही एकदम डायरेक्टली एमपीएससीची परीक्षेची तयारी करतो म्हणता, तर तुम्हाला रायटिंग स्किलमध्ये तुम्हाला प्रॉब्लेम्स येतील. कारण एखाद्या विषयावर समजा एसे लिहायचं असेल किंवा कारण एमपीएससीच्या परीक्षेमध्ये जो सेकंड एक्झाम असते, सेकंड पेपर असतो मेन्सचा, मेन्सच्या पेपरमध्ये तुम्हाला एसे लिहावा लागतो आणि तो इंग्लिशमध्ये लिहायचा असतो. तर तुम्हाला लिहिण्यासाठी, रायटिंग स्किलसाठी तुम्हाला आधी तुमची व्होकॅबुलरी डेव्हलप करावी लागेल. तुम्हाला सेंटेन्सेस कसे बनतात, ॲक्युरेट इंग्लिशमध्ये सेंटेन्स लिहायचं असेल मला एखादं आयडिया सांगायची आणि ती सांगायसाठी कोणत्या प्रकारचं सेंटेन्स मला लिहावं लागेल, तर हे समजण्यासाठी तुम्हाला टेन्सेसचा जो भाग आहे तो आधी समजून घ्यावा लागेल. तर माझा म्हणण्याचा उद्देश असा आहे की तुम्ही एखादी एक्झाम समजा टार्गेट केली असेल आणि तुम्हाला समजा असं वाटतं की बाबा त्या तुलनेमध्ये तुमची कपॅसिटी, तुमचं पोटेन्शियल कमी आहे, तर आधी ग्राउंड लेवलपासून सुरुवात करा. बेसिक्स ऑफ ग्रॅमर समजून घ्या, फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ लँग्वेज समजून घ्या, टेन्सेस, पार्ट ऑफ स्पीच, नॅरेशन, व्हॉइस, अशा प्रकारच्या ह्या ज्या गोष्टी आहेत त्या समजून घ्या. त्यासाठी बाजारामध्ये इंग्लिश ग्रॅमरवरती फार सोप्या भाषेमध्ये पुस्तकं आहेत, ही पुस्तकं थोडीशी वाचल्यानंतर मग आपण हायर लेवलच्या इंग्लिशमध्ये आपण कॉन्सन्ट्रेट केलं पाहिजे.
सर माझे म्हणजे ग्रामर ओके ओके आहे सर, मला ग्रामर चांगलं येतं
बरं,
बट माझं वोकॅबलरी ठीक नाही सर त्यामुळे.
तर वोकॅबलरी आपण कशी इम्प्रूव्ह करू शकतो, मी आत्ताच ज्या सरांनी जो प्रश्न विचारला मी त्याच्यामध्ये सांगितलं की वोकॅबलरी इम्प्रूव्ह करण्यासाठी तुम्ही न्यूजपेपर्स वाचा, रोज किमान अर्धा तास न्यूजपेपर वाचा, जे जे नवीन शब्द तुम्हाला वाटतात ते एका कागदावर लिहून घ्या, त्याचा अर्थ माहीत करा, ते पाठ करा, कारण तुम्हाला काही नवीन वर्ड तुमच्या मेमरीमध्ये गेल्याशिवाय ते इनकॉर्पोरेट होणार नाही, तुम्ही लँग्वेजमध्ये यूज करू शकणार नाही. त्यासाठी डेलिबरेटली जाणीवपूर्वक तुम्हाला प्रयत्न करावा लागेल तुमची व्होकॅबुलरी वाढवण्यासाठी. तर हा एक मार्ग आहे वर्तमानपत्राचा. दुसरा मार्ग मी सांगितला की रोज तुम्ही एका कागदावर नवीन 5 शब्द लिहा आणि ते 5 शब्द तुम्ही त्याचे अर्थ शोधून ते लक्षात घ्या आणि त्या 5 शब्दाचा उपयोग तुम्ही करण्याचा पण प्रयत्न करा, मनातल्या मनात किंवा लिहून पहा. अशा प्रकारे रोज 5 शब्द तुम्ही नवीन समजा ऐकले आणि तुम्ही शिकले तर एका महिन्यामध्ये साधारणतः 5 × 15 150 नवीन शब्द तुम्ही शिकता एका महिन्यामध्ये. अशा प्रकारे वोकॅबुलरी ही आपोआप वाढत नाही, नथिंग हॅपन्स ऑटोमॅटिकली, ते तुम्हाला जाणीवपूर्वक प्रयत्न करून वाढवावं लागेल. इंग्लिशचे छोटेसे नॉवेल्स आहेत, सिम्पल सोप्या भाषेतले, हे वाचायचं. जसं आपण न्यूज पेपर्स वाचायचे, तर अशा प्रकारे जेव्हा जेव्हा नवीन शब्द आपल्याला दिसतात ते आपण त्याचा पाठकडे डिक्शनरी पण ठेवायची, नवीन शब्दांचे अर्थ काय आहेत ते आपण समजून घ्यायचं. अशा प्रकारे ऍडिशन ही अशी वारंवार हेतूपूर्वक केल्या जाऊ शकते, आपोआप होणार नाही ते.
राईट सर,
थँक्यू सर.
ओके,
एनीवन एल्स हु इज विलिंग टू आस्क द क्वेश्चन?
यस सर.
सर
प्रश्न आहे, मी एमपीएससी ची परीक्षा, सर मला जो सीसॅटचा पेपर आहे दुसरा पेपर पूर्व परीक्षेचा, तर माझ्या अगोदरच सर इतका न्यूनगंड निर्माण झाला आहे आणि अगोदर करून सुद्धा घेतली इतरांनी पण मित्रांनी की तो खूप कठीण असतो, तर सर ते खरंच का खूप कठीण असते काय आणि त्याच्यासाठी खूप मेहनत करावं लागतं असं म्हणतात?
सर्वात प्रथम तुम्ही आधी एमपीएससीचा जो हा येतो सर्वात पहिली गोष्ट, तुम्ही एमपीएससीचा जो जी परीक्षा तुम्हाला द्यायची आहे तिचा आधी सिलॅबस, नेमका सिलॅबस पहा. सिलॅबस मध्ये तुम्हाला त्या पेपर मध्ये कोणत्या म्हणजे किती मार्काचा वेटेज आहे ते बघा, कशा प्रकारचे प्रश्न राहतील ते बघा आणि त्या हिशोबाने तुम्हाला तयारी करावी लागेल. तसं कोणी समजा तुम्हाला म्हटलं की बाबा खूपच कठीण आहे, तर अशातली कोणतीच गोष्ट नाही जगात, काही असं काही इम्पॉसिबल नाही. आजच्या काळामध्ये तर अजिबात नाही. यू आर ऍक्च्युली व्हेरी लकी दॅट यू आर लिव्हिंग इन सच काइंड ऑफ अ टेक्नॉलॉजिकल इरा वेअर यू हॅव लॉट ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. तुमच्याकडे इतकी सारी संसाधनं आहेत की घरी बसल्या बसल्या कुठल्याही ग्रंथालयात न जाता तुम्ही इतकी सारी पुस्तकं वाचू शकता. त्याच्यामुळे हे मानण्याची अजिबात गरज नाही की तुमच्यामध्ये काही पोटेन्शियल नाही आहे किंवा न्यूनगंड आहे, तो अजिबात काढून टाकायचा. फक्त आधी त्या प्रॉब्लेमला सिस्टमॅटिकली फेस करा, म्हणजे नेमका सिलेबस कसा आहे तो बघा, कोणता कोणता पार्ट आहे त्याच्यामध्ये तो बघा, मग तो पार्ट तुम्हाला आता सध्या तुम्हाला त्याची किती माहिती आहे ते बघा आणि ते थोडंसं इम्प्रूव्ह करायसाठी तुम्हाला जे काही पुस्तकं जे काही तुम्हाला इम्प्रूव्ह करण्यासाठी वाचावं लागेल किंवा प्रिपरेशन करावं लागेल त्या दृष्टीने आपली प्रिपरेशनची प्लॅनिंग सुरू करायची.
थँक्यू सो मच सर.
ओके
ओके, एनीवन एल्स? Well, so thank you so much friends for your active participation into this question answer session, and I'm thankful to Dr. Sanjay Shinde sir also for his wonderful answers. I hope you have satisfied yourself and your queries. Now let us come to the final part of this webinar. I would like to ask Mr. Shirsagar sir to propose vote of thanks on this occasion. Over to Shirsagar sir.
Thank you sir. Thank you for giving me this opportunity. First of all, I thank Dr. Sanjay Shende sir, associate professor, Shivaji College Rajura, for igniting the minds of our UG and PG friends who are actually preparing for competitive examination. He focused on so many issues regarding LSRW, regarding English in and he I hope so many students are benefited from his talk. Secondly, I thank Dr. Bakre sir, the principal of our college, for motivating us and providing us the platform like Webex to arrange such type of webinars and talks for our students. Then after, I thank Dr. Ujjair sir, our head Department of English, for providing this opportunity for the student and for being a host and for arranging all the things for this webinar. I also thank Mr. Barbudhe for presenting over here and for the what you call the assistant in technical help. And I thank other faculty members for being present here and for motivating us. And last but not the least, I thank all the students for their patience and for listening for and for asking the questions. I thank you one and all. And I announce, with the permission of chairperson and the speaker, to end this session. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you.